Okay, this video is going out for Jake. Jake, let me show you what you did wrong here, buddy. Okay, here's your test, first of all. You can see the ones you missed right here, and we're going to go over them. But let me just show you right off the bat. When you studied the video, you did not write down the formula correctly. Okay, so I know you say you studied and I let you retest and you still didn't do it. And right here, if you would have just gotten this one formula right, you would have gotten credit, and that's what you're looking for. You did everything right. You did side times the sine of the angle. The only thing you did not do was divide by 2. It's a triangle. The area of a triangle is always divided by 2. If you would have divided your answer by 2, you would have gotten number 1 right. And you would have gotten number 6 right. These two problems alone would have been enough for you to get what you're trying to get. So that's why you missed number 1 and number 6. You should have divided by 2. And you did not. All right, let's go on. Number 10. Number 10 says the circumference. Right away, you should have on your work right here, circumference equals pi times diameter, and you should have substituted the 40 pi. This problem was on the video, sir, and you should have gotten it correct. You divide by pi, the pi's cancel, so you get the diameter is equal to 40. You have that. Okay, so let me find out why this one was marked wrong. Find the circumference, find the diameter, find the radius. You got the diameter, you got the radius. But you did not find the length of the arc. Okay? Well, the arc is 80 degrees. So the way you find, let's say, here's your circle. And here's 90 degrees. 80 degrees is about here. So this is 80 degrees, let's say. To find the distance from here to here called the arc length, you have to take the fraction, 80 over 360, times pi times diameter. So the diameter you have right is 40, and you got to multiply by 3.14. So the fact, what I'm trying to tell you is, you should have multiplied a fraction of the whole circumference. And you don't have that. Yes, you did find the diameter. Yes, you did find the radius. But you did not find the most important piece, which is the actual length of that 80 degree arc. Number 10, the next one you missed was number 11. Here's number 11 right here. It says find the length. It looks like you were starting off right, X, P, Y, and you have 270 over 360. All of that's good, okay? But it should be pi times diameter. Again, you're talking about the length. The formula is fraction times circumference, which is pi times diameter. So you should have had, you got your fraction right, but it should have been 3.14, which is pi, and then times the diameter. Well, 12 is not the diameter. The diameter is 24. So I don't think you knew the formula for that. And that's why you missed that one. So two of those. The next one is number 14. Here's number 14. Find the area of a circle. The formula for area of a circle is pi radius squared. So it's 3.14 times the radius squared. Well, this is your diameter. So you take 4.1 and you divide by 2. And it's certainly not 1. Half of 4 is 2. So you, something's wrong there, okay? You just didn't know what radius and diameter is. I don't know. 4.1 divided by 2. I end up with 2.05. So there's your mistake there. Number 15. Number 15, again, this one was on there, okay? It says they, let's see, let me make sure. They took a wheel, they rolled it, and they measured 30 centimeters. So here's your wheel. which is a circle, and they rolled it, they marked it, and they rolled it until the mark came down again, and they measured 30 centimeters. That's circumference. So circumference, which is 30, equals pi times diameter. So you got to divide by pi. So it's going to be diameter is equal to 30 divided by 3.14. When you do that, Jake, you get 9.6 approximately. So 9.6, let's round that off. It says find the area. Well, area equals, area of a circle is pi times the radius squared. We don't know, that's the diameter. So take that, divide it by 2, and I get the radius is about 4.8. And that's the way you work that problem. So you got to multiply those three. Let's see what else you missed. Number 15, and again, that was on the practice test, so you should have known that one. Number 19, they want that slither. In order to get this slither right here, you have to first find area of the sector, so area of sector minus the triangle, or area of the triangle. That's the basic formula. Now, this one wasn't on the video, but we have done this in the past. And I think it was on the Wall of Fame as well. Well, here's the area of the sector. They're telling you what it is. So all of this is 12.25 times pi minus the area of a triangle. The base is 7 and the height is 7. So it's 1/2 the base times the height. So basically, it's going to be this minus 1/2 of 49. So 49 divided by 2. So again, take 12.25 times 3.14, and I get 38.5. So it's approximately 38.5 minus, take 49 and divide by 2. I get 24.5. And when you subtract, you get 14. Approximately. All right. This one right here, we're going to skip this one. It was more complicated, but you can see that you missed some that you should not have missed. All right. Now on this one right here, it says find the area. You put an X right here, and you do the track method. Now, you need to know that the formula for area of a triangle is 1/2 the base times the height. And again, we had this one on the video. So you got to get the base, this whole piece right here. The height we know is 9, so it's going to be whatever 9 times the base is.
Yes. Jake Swirsky left it. Can you read it? I don't think he... Is he still up there?
No, he left to go to work.
All right, I already emailed them. I'm going to put it on YouTube. That's what I'm doing right now. So, whatever. I appreciate it. Thank you, sir. All right, so Jake, we need to do the track method. So it's X over 9, and then you come back down equals 9 over 13. So it's basically 81 divided by 13. So 81 divided by 13 equals, I get 6.2. So this piece right here is 6.2, approximately. Now we're going to add, Jake, to the 13. So that's going to be 19.2 is the base. So 19.2. So we're going to take 19.2 times 9, press equals, and then divide by 2. I get 86.4. Okay? So you had to use the track method first. This one right here, you didn't have to do the track method. It's just base times height. It's a parallelogram, Jake. So it's base, which is 38, times the height, which is 24. Now, you shouldn't have missed that one. So you missed a few easy ones. I'm going to pause the video here. You can watch it and figure out what you did wrong. I'm real sorry, okay, but I did give you enough chances. Have a good day.